खुबोर का बातेसी टीवी लवन राशिफी दा का ऑरेंज निसान लूम्स ऑफ पोनिया फैब्रिक चिलोंग रिंकट बट का फिटोरियम का दुकान की तियार किलान में का भातम हका डोर का बबित हनोंग थमाई ओल्ड बीट हाउस शिलोंग
ऑनरेबल डिप्टी स्पीकर सर
जॉर्ज पिलिंग द प्लीज इनिशिएटिव डिस्कशन बट बिफोर यू स्टार्ट योर डिस्कशन
सर
I would like to remind you this is a short duration discussion so please be short also
will be discussion. adequately short sir I rise to move the short duration discussion under rules 50 of the rules of procedure and conduct of business regarding the news item appearing in the local Khasi Daily Mawfor on 15th March 2021 under the caption hapo tengka arspa shakwe kejelang hame halia tengka Saus Pak Sanpo Kadun Rus Pak Kadok Masih.
You may initiate your discussion.
Honorable Deputy Speaker, sir, at the outset, I'd like to appreciate you for admitting this very important short duration discussion pertaining to the news item, as mentioned, appearing in the local Khasi Daily Mawfor. Sir, the news item reflects on several issues. I'll just point out the issues that have been reported in the news item, sir. Number one, the compulsion of our butchers to increase the prices due to the decrease in supply of cattle. Number two, the cost of beef is the highest in Shillong when compared to other locations in Northeast. Number three, the rise of prices is due to the rampant cattle smuggling to Bangladesh through our international borders. Number four, the non-regulation of the market has led to competitive pricing wherein the genuine butchers are outbidded. Number five, sir, the police and BSF have not been vigilant enough to curtail cattle smuggling activities and apprehend the culprits. Number six, in spite of numerous petitions, the state government has not heard the problems faced by our local butchers and their problems persist due to inaction of the state government. So these are the six points that have been mentioned in the news item, sir. And I think the Honorable Deputy Chief Minister is well aware of these news items and also the continuous problems faced by the butchers and especially with the increase in the prices of beef, how people have been affected. Sir, the current challenges for cattle sector is manifold. We have had a long discussion on this, sir, regarding the dairy mission as well. And Meghalaya is amongst the only eight states that have not banned cow slaughter so far. And beef has been a staple diet for our tribal citizens, sir, and the cheapest source of protein. So the only cattle market for a mandi, as we call it, sir, in the mainland, we know it is known as mandi, but here this is the Yau Masi, we call it, in Kanapara, sir. That is the only market, sir, where it is the recognized market for cattle. Trade. And the day-to-day operations of the cattle market have been managed by the aim of MMLM through the district council as rural markets fall under the district council, sir. Therefore, sir, the district council, the MMLM, they have a major stake in ensuring a steady and smooth supply of cattle. Now, recently also, sir, the Animal Husbandry and Veterinary Department have started their activities by posting doctors in the market, sir, to check on the health of the cattle, as whether they are fit to be transported or not. That is the responsibility of the veterinary department that has been vested to the doctors that are present at the site, sir, in the market. Sir, now, sir, there are many problems. One, sir, as per my analysis, there is no proper identification of genuine buyers who are the authentic butchers and who are operating in this entire trade, sir. Therefore, anyone can purchase the cattle from the Khanapara cattle market without checking the veracity of the buyer. Number two, sir, the doctors present in the cattle market are not on a full-time basis. They are currently outnumbered, sir, because so much of demand, only one or two doctors, and the doctor that is posted there is also, sir, or given the responsibility to look after the cattle market. He is actually a doctor from the Barnihat veterinary dispensary. So added responsibility to the doctor there, sir. There is poor infrastructure, sir, in the Kanapara cattle market, as animals have to be there for at least 1 to 3 days. Then there's lack of proper infrastructure creates problems, not only for the buyers, but the cattle also do not get attended to, sir, in a proper manner. So these are the few problems, which are the major issues leading to the problems of demand and supply and price rise, which we are seeing now, and we have seen in the past as well, sir. So to improve the current prevailing system, sir, which would bring long-term measures, I have a few suggestions, sir. Perhaps they may be of use to the state government, sir. Number one, sir, to start a registration system of genuine butchers. All the genuine butchers who are operating across the state, sir, they should be registered with the veterinary department. They should be identified also, sir, along with the butchers association. These genuine butchers operating across the state, an identification process be started, registration process be started, so that once they register, sir, they will be the benefactors of the cattle market there in Kanapara. No unknown citizen, no unknown registered person will just walk in and buy cattle. At least the genuine traders will be, their interest should be protected, sir, through a registration system. And perhaps the registration system also should capture the actual requirement of that particular butcher. Maybe one butcher may require one cattle per week. Some butchers may require 10 cattle per week, sir, depending on the market they're catering to. So this itself will put in a self-regulation system, sir, where the demand supply can be regulated based on the the requirements of the butchers. Sir, perhaps this registration system will be able to curtail the outbidding that is happening, the outpricing that is happening, and the genuine butchers, sir, they will not be affected because they could not meet with the price that is being placed for the cattle, sir. So through this also, sir, I would like to make a suggestion that a market committee, perhaps there might be one, sir, but then the market committee also should be strengthened to ensure that there's a joint monitoring and management of the cattle market, sir, including the veterinary department, district council, the CM of Himamaliam, and most importantly, sir, the stakeholders, that is the Butchers Association. So through this, perhaps the market committee can bring in an online system to monitor the purchases, the cattle that is coming in, the cattle that is going out, so that at least through this online system, sir, there will be no fraudulent means of operations in the cattle market. Sir, dedicated veterinary doctors should be deployed in the cattle market, sir. As of now, sir, there is one or two doctors there, and all they do is certify. Now, because of the burden, sir, they cannot verify as to whether these cattle are being purchased by genuine butchers or somebody is trying to outbid the butchers and take away the cattle. One who has got more money, he buys 200 cattle. One who is actually doing genuine business, he cannot even afford one cattle also, sir. Therefore, sir, this is leading to the price rise as well. So, with the full-time doctors present there, sir, the genuineness of the entire trade can be verified, genuine butchers can be allowed. At the same time, we will also know the end destination as to where the cattle are being taken to. Sir, the infrastructure, as I had mentioned, sir, in the submission, the infrastructure of the cattle market is very poor. So we need to upgrade infrastructure, sir. Better pens, better the isolation pens should be there, so that at least the cattle who are unhealthy, they can be isolated from the ones that are healthy. This will also help in long-term practices and the entire operations of the market, sir. So these are a few suggestions, sir, that would perhaps rein in the unregulated market, sir, and a proper mechanism be put in place so that whatever we are seeing now, sir, the unprecedented rise in the prices, we are denying people of a good source of protein, and being only one of the few states that still allow cattle slaughter, the trade does not suffer because it is linked to livelihoods, multiple livelihoods, and also linked to the local to our diet. So therefore, sir, many other suggestions can come in the course of time in order to promote also cattle rearing. That, in fact, can create employment opportunities for our youths. At the same time, if you can build the fundamentals of meat processing industry with a legal business approach to supply to Bangladesh. So perhaps this will open new opportunities and a better tomorrow for our stakeholders, especially our youth. So these are a few opening remarks, sir, and suggestions for the kind attention of the Honourable Deputy Chief Minister and the government, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Honourable Member P.T. Sokme, you can take the floor now.
Thank you very much, sir, for allowing me to participate in this important short duration. So this is a very serious issue. I would like to brought into in front of the House that Honourable Member from Umroi have brought in his own way how to affect the livelihood of the beef seller, the beef consumer, and also the livelihood of the people. So for information of the Honourable Deputy Chief Minister, he knew, and also his Principal Secretary, Commissioner Secretary, for information of him that Kanapara cattle market now is closed for 1 week. So why has happened that it has closed? Because there's one organization called the Gaon Gyan Foundation, and also with other organization that People for Animals India. They have lodged the complaint to the Jorobat police station, lodged FIR to Jorobat police station. Then Jorobat police station, they have contact me to Kanapara police station. Both of them, they're working together. They've go and read about of that cattle market in that Kanapara market. Then have ceased and no more cattle market there at Kanapara, sir. So it is a very serious matter because this organization called the People for Animal India, they have many charges. I saw in that social media, which she had already been spoken. It is her right, because I've already formed his own organization. Then you have also the Gaon Gyan Foundation. They have said that this is not a proper, that a cattle of 1,000 cattle can transport it to Meghalaya every day. So in addition to that, sir, I also like, sir, I'm very much concerned for this, because now it seems that unless the government intervene, it is very difficult, again, that the people of Meghalaya, especially the Khasi Jaintias, maybe the Garos, mean that from other side of Gauhati, from Assam, Gauhati will go straight to the Gauhati Hills. From our side, because we have to, cattle have to come through Gauhati, to Nongpo, to Ribhoi district, to Khasi and West. Maybe Jaintias somehow, in what way, the, some of the road, but will affect badly, because the cattle is coming from other part of the country, that is especially from the north is coming of cattle. If the cattle now, we could see that so much of restriction from now on, especially on the road from the Gauhati coming into, from Assam coming to Meghalaya. So, because according to what that organization said, that in Petrok, only 6 cattle can be carried, not 30, 40, or more than that. Then also they have already been charged. How that injured cattle that can be sent to Shillong and can also can be smuggling to Bangladesh, they also that is a fail on the side of doctors who have checked of the cattle. So that matter, I've already said, is a very serious matter unless the government intervene. Very difficult situation, sir. I don't know whether that the cattle market at Kanapara, whether they can open back or not. We knew that that market, that areas, it belonged to the same of Malayam. It belonged with the with the approval of the KHDC as per Market Act and regulation of the KHDC. That is the areas belong to the KHDC. So for information of the Honourable Minister, yesterday that matter has been in the District Court of Nong Po, that the people for animal, they have claimed that 371 cattle. People for animal, they have only claimed that cattle 371. Then Sim Amulim also, now they have only claimed for that cattle belong to the Sim, and also because it is on the door bar. But it seems that the court have not passed any judgment. But now it's still lying with that. Unless the government be a party of that case, I could see that if you leave alone, only that Sim Amulim, even KHDC, government be a party of that. So I won't think that we can win the case. So like already said, that now that issue of getting the cattle to few district, SP Castles, then Ribhoi district and Giant Hills, even West Castle, very scared of getting the cattle. We could see that I could see that time will come that we will not have any more opportunity of eating beef. Or we the Khasi said, and I come back at Sapoy Kapoor, or Myo Bam Dok Masisho. There's a time that I could see because of the situation is going on. This organization that People for Animal India have come forward. Gown, we understand that the Gown Gyan Foundation, we need the background. Who's this Gown Gyan Foundation? So now is a time that it seems that we have to be very, very cautious. Anything that we are doing now is very cautious. We have find the problem each and everyone, a department will find the problem. My appeal to all the people that it is a time that we have to be very cautious whatever we are doing, because we live in a stage of very, very difficult. So, as an MLA of all I can see, because that is the areas of main people have been earned the livelihood from the beef seller, beef consumer, and also that many of them they have been getting employment directly, indirectly involved on this business. So it is a very particular condition. I'm sympathized with them. The honourable member from Umbroy have already said many have to close the shop because no buyer. Even if sometime they can sell the beef, even of 30 kg, 40 kg, even 40 kg, 50 kg, or now even 5 kg, they cannot sell the beef. No buyers because of the cost. So the main cost here, as we understand, so because of the cattle is no more cattle coming from the Kanapara. That is the main cause that the price of the beef has rise. The beef, Khasi Giant's beef auction, they are compelled to increase of the cattle because they are buying at a high cost. But even then, 600 for them, they cannot get much of the profit. So, this is the matter that I have already brought in the floor of the house. But like I have already said by honourable member from Roy, because many of the cattle have been going illegally to Bangladesh. That is very unfortunate that we cannot stop illegal transportation or illegal of selling of cattle to Bangladesh. Even that members of the People for Animal India, she said that most of the cattle have been sold to Bangladesh illegally. This is very serious. It seems that the person who have been staying in the border areas, like we entrusted this matter to the Border Security Force, BSF, it seems they have not doing the job properly. So now my request to Honourable Minister that intervene to be the part of that case, MMLM, then district council with the state government, so that how we can get chance to open. That's number one. Number two, sir, that this cattle of 371, it seems that this cattle, if we cannot move in a proper way, it seems it will go back. I mean, it will go back to the place which this cattle has come. This cattle, we understand, they have been bought by the butcher, but it seems that but unless the government fought seriously, so I'm very much. I feel for those in butcher that they cannot get back of this 371. So this is a submission. I'll let you bring him into the floor of the house. But like I've already said, we would like when this business of the cattle should go on. Like we have only been, that's a butcher, they have only been in the job for the long time. We would like to see to continue. And especially that Kanapara cattle market, which have been running more than 40 years, it is a very unfortunate. So 40 years now has been closed. Unless we fight back, difficult estate that we will lose one after another, especially for that whatever it belonged to us. With these two words, sir, I leave it to the government. I'm sure that the Honourable Deputy Chief Minister, we are very much happy. He's a senior man. He knew better, and he knew how to. Move the case in the right direction so that whatever problem faced by the Khasi Gentius Board Association and also with the Kanapara cattle market, we can open back with the advice and also with the sincere effort of the Honourable Deputy Chief Minister with the support of the officers from the Veterinary Department. With these words, sir, thank you, sir.
Thank you. May I request the Minister in charge to reply, please.
Mr. Deputy Speaker, sir, at the outset, I am very thankful to Sri George Pilingdo, Honourable MLA from Umroy, as well as our Honourable MLA from Maulai, who already made a submission in this August House, the concerns about the price rise of beef in the open market throughout the state of Meghalaya. Sir, the submission suggestions made by the honourable members is specially noted down by me. And the news item which appeared at Umapur, dated 15 March 2021. The department had a detailed discussion with the office bearers of the Khasi Jaintia Butchers Welfare Association, led by its president, Sri Generous Warlarpi. The purpose of the meeting is to obtain from them all the detailed information on the sudden escalation of price of beef in the market, ranging from 450 to 600 rupees, as published in the newspaper mentioned above. Briefly, from the discussion, few issues were informed by the association. As already mentioned by the honourable members, both the honourable members from Umroy and also from Maulai, sir, there are two issues here. As far as marketing of cattle or beef throughout the state. One is the issue of marketing, where our honourable member mentioned about the regulation of market, or regulated market, I should say. And the point number two is, who will regulate or put in place the regulation on this market. I think we all know that the market set up in the sixth schedule area is purely the subject of the district council. So the district council can create and also can have a regulation in the respective area and with the understanding of the local authority or the same, the right, and the HIMA. Yes, sir, we are aware that the market, cattle market at Baridwa, run by the same of Malay and established by the KHADC for many, many years now. Recently, what happened was the district administration, the police department from Ribhoi district, they entertained one FIR filed by one organization in the name of Animal Welfare by the name of Jian Foundation Delhi. Jian Foundation Delhi. And that also happens in the market day. So they filed FIR. FIR was registered. And ultimately, now the case is lying with the district court at Nongpo. So as far as this particular FIR is concerned, I will not say anything because it is lying with the Honorable District Court. But outside this FIR, sir, I would like to also share here the concern of the Honorable Members. Yes, we realize today that regulation has to be in place. So informally, just a few days back, I called the CM of the KHADC, along with the CM of Malay. I told them that why don't you come up with a proper regulation as far as cattle market is concerned, which was located long time back or established long time back in Khanapara, Baridwa, Ribhoi district. Because the role of the government and the role of the veterinary department is so limited. What we can only do from the department is we can assist the KHDC or the SAME of Malay in checking the health condition of the animals as prescribed by the Act. That is the bounded duty of the veterinary department and of the government, because we will not allow animals to come into our state until and unless it is found fit and healthy. On the basis of that, sir, we posted one doctor in that particular market. And during the market day, this doctor will examine each and every animal, be it 100 numbers, be it 1,000 numbers. And after checking up, then the animals will be kept in that place itself. And next day, the consumers came in to Khanapara, to that market, and they buy maybe 10 numbers, maybe 5 numbers, maybe 3 numbers. according to their requirement, and thereafter they take the transportation. Transportation movement takes place to different designated places. But challan is issued in the name of health certificate. Veterinary officer, doctor, will issue the challan, or it is known as health certificate, and also they specify the destination. If it has to be taken to Shillong, that very certificate or challan issued by our doctor is mentioned clearly, the destination is Shillong. Or if it is in Nongstoin, the destination is Nongstoin. If it is Jowai, destination is Jowai. And these certificates issued by our doctor posted at Market Cattle Khanapara will be also handed over to the transporter, and one copy also to the police authorities, where they need to check the movement of transportation accordingly. So these are the issues where the Veterinary Department is doing as per the prescribed norms under the Act, and the Act is known as Prevention on Cruelty of Animals Act, issued by the Government of India. So that is the point number one, sir, where I would like to share here. Then number two, sir, in fact, as I said to you, now the discussion is on with the KHDC, with the CM of Malim, to identify a proper place. If they can identify a proper place, create a new market over there, what we can step in from the government side or from the department veterinary, we will create infrastructure permanently in that location in the form of dispensary, where the staff and the doctors can be stationed there 24/7. They can be there 24/7. But this particular place where the market is running, it is so limited, we don't have space at all. Therefore, we have to ask the doctor to be there morning till evening, till the examination is completed to each and every animals. So, sir, this process is on. So I'm sure maybe sooner or later, this council, along with this aim of Malim, will be able to identify a place, a proper place, as I said to you. And from the department, from the government, we are there to help them out. And we will also be there in creating a permanent infrastructure wherever the area is identified by the district council and the CM of Malim. So the next point is, yes, I think our member, they did mention about the smuggling of cattle to Bangladesh. Time and again, joint meeting was held with the concerned authority of PSF as well as the police department to check the illegal smuggling of cattle that is happening even till today. And this is also one of the reasons which leads to shortage of cattle, and ultimately it affects the beef price in the entire state of Meghalaya. And this is the ongoing process where the meeting is always held jointly from the government side, veterinary department, then the SPs, the DCs, as well as the BSF authorities to find out ways and means how to stop the illegal smuggling of cattle across the country to Bangladesh. So this is done and this is being done, and we are going to do it, sir, on a regular basis to reduce, as I said to you, the smuggling that take place in different parts of our state. So, sir, I would also like to say here once again, for the information of this August House, in fact, till today, there is no such notification or order, as far as our state is concerned, which is against slaughtering of cattle. There is no ban, no such ban, and there is no act also which is totally against slaughtering of cattle, because we knew well, our honourable members did mention that Meghala state is the highest consuming state, I should say, in beef, and we will make sure, now on, we will make sure, and we did have a meeting also with the concerned district administration, and we will continue to have a meeting with the district administration, that now on, FIR filed by anybody has to be examined properly by the concerned authority. I've already spoken personally even to the SP. Why should you just entertain the FIR filed by the organization from Delhi without knowing anything about the prevailing regulation act that we are obeying or following as per the guidance of the act and provisions? So they should not do that. So now, sir, as far as the temporary closure of the market that has happened a few days back in the Khanapara, the Baridwa, again, I've already spoken, as I said to you, to the CM of Malim, and then to the this council, as well as to Deputy Commissioner Ribhoy District. They are going to, again, reopen up this market, maybe within a day or two. That I can assure the House that the market will again reopen very soon from today. So, sir, with this few clarification I made, as I said to you once again, I am so thankful to the honourable members, Mr. George Lingdo and processed Saukmi, honourable members, who has already made their submission suggestions. So these issues has been noted down, and once the assembly session is over, I will again personally call a meeting how to overcome all these problems that we have in the state, sir. With this submission, I resume my seat, sir. Thank you.
Sir, I thank the Honourable Deputy CM, sir, for the detailed reply concerning this particular issue, which is really hampering the entire cattle sector, sir. Sir, I also like to thank him for highlighting the ignorance of the police department, sir, when as a state we have already passed a resolution rejecting the act imposed by the central government, because prevention of cruelty to animals is a concurrent subject. So perhaps this ignorance, sir, may be ensured that all the people, all the police, and all the district admissions, they are made aware of the law, sir, and such frivolous complaints are not being entertained in the near future. Sir, based on the submission of the Honourable Deputy CM, he has already said that the veterinary doctors, they give a health certificate, and only upon the issuance of the health certificate will the cattle be allowed to be transported. That's why, sir, I was very categorical in my submission that the registration process should be between the Veterinary Department and the Khasi Butcher Association, which therefore does not infringe upon the operations of the rural markets, which fall under the District Council under the Sixth Schedule, sir. Therefore, sir, these things should be segregated. The registration is outside the market, sir. It is an operation which is and a regulation that is happening outside the market, and the veterinary doctors should give the health certificate only upon the butchers or the citizens producing the registration number or registration identity card that will be issued by the department, sir. So these two things should be separated, sir, not to take in totality, which will mix with the operations of the rural of the cattle market, which falls under the district council, sir. These are my few added submissions, sir. And again, I again once again thank the Honourable Deputy CM for the efforts taken, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yes, sir. The point raised by our Honourable Member from Umroi, yes, sir. I think the process of registration or the process of issuing health certificate or challan, I think we will look into, we will revisit it and how to improve it between the butcher association and the department. And the point number two raised by honourable member from Olai about process of May, I've already told from the beginning that now the this council, KHDC, CM of Malay, they are on the job of shifting the cattle market from there because their space is so limited, and we already advise them also to have a bigger space where we can create, in addition to the market, we can also create infrastructure from the veterinary department, sir.